In the 80s, when the young people of urban America had an itch, brothers like Grandmaster Flash came with the scratch bass.
Because see, this whole hip-hop culture was like a conglomeration of minds.
Rap music had come up from the underground towards the mainstream with a force that wasn't about to be ignored. Critics called it a flash in the pan. But where the music world resisted, BET assisted by making a unique place rappers could call their own.
A place called Rap City.
Rap City was built in 1989, complete with the mayor, old schools, new jacks, b-boys, and It was the only place on TV where street Picassos could paint their stories freely, stories of triumph and tragedy.
Mom, I would never wish death on nobody, you know, because ain't no coming back from that.
Knowing that a nation divided against itself will fall, Rap City remains common ground, baby.
Y'all know how we do it. East Coast, West Coast, worldwide. We're defining the hip-hop nation right here on Rap City.
I must confess my destiny's manifested.
20 years after being written off, hip-hop artists are straight flossing with multi-platinum joints, television and film projects.
Devon Jets, Wu-Tang Clan coming at you, baby.
This is Snoop Doggy Dogg's Dr. Dre live and direct from the Chronic Zone, and we chilling on Rap City.
But Rap City is still home and going strong, baby, thanks to slamming hosts, banging guests, and an audience that's off the hinges.